Hello, Klaus here. Here is a super quick update video because Blackmagic just announced a new camera update for the pocket line cameras, and that's meaning the pocket camera 4K, 6K, 6K Pro, and the full frame. And all of these updates should work in all of them. So in this video, we're going to run through the update and I'm going to test it out on the Blackmagic Pocket Camera 4K because I have two of those, so we can see a before and after kind of thing. Also, just to run through these specs here on the update, just some of the things I am really, really excited about is you can now actually delete clips on the camera. You have never been able to do that on a Blackmagic camera ever. So now you can actually go in and delete individual clips, which is super cool. We're also going to get the ability to upload clips directly up to the cloud and into DaVinci Resolve projects from any of the cameras. So you can hook up your mobile phone onto your camera so you can upload your files directly up to DaVinci Resolve projects. Super cool. There is also some improvements to the gyro stabilization that we can also test out, which is going to be super cool, I think. But let's just update the camera and have a look at what's the difference. So let's head into Blackmagic's homepage and pick up the update. And it is a free update, by the way. So it still amazes me that Blackmagic, after, what, 6+ years, still do updates for their cameras, in this case for the Pocket 4K. So let's start to update. So now the firmware is downloaded and I'm running the update now. So I'm just going to go in here and let's say update. Update software camera now. And we're going to update that. And keep in mind when you're doing the update that the camera is going to wipe all of your settings out. So please do back up your color profiles and stuff like that, or your settings if you have any of those on the camera. So I'm super excited about this update. So let's get the camera updated and let's start to do the test. So see you in the studio in just 1 second. Okay, so let's just start to boot up the camera. This camera right here is the one with the update, and here we have the other with the old firmware. So we're going to boot these up at the same time if possible. Let's go. And let's see. So this is what we actually see on the updated version. We are going to have this menu, and of course I'll just say there's a bunch of new languages, I think. There's a lot of languages anyway, but let's go into continue on English, and then we're just going to pop into the menu on both. So on the first page, everything looks pretty normal, I think. So we're just going to run through the pages quickly here. Also think that looks pretty normal, nothing new here. And I don't think that we are going to see that much in the record systems anyways. So everything looks just the same. Vertical recording, I don't know if that is a new one. Actually, I think this is maybe this is actually some new settings for vertical recording, which is kind of cool. So we'll have to look into that later. If you go into the monitor settings, I think everything here looks just the same. I don't think there should be any like major things here. New. Everything looks just the same. So we'll go into the audio settings. I also would think that the audio settings would be the same. They are. So we'll go into the setup because here I think the difference should be. So first off, here we have the settings. There's actually something going on here. Because on the setup here, we have some new updates, the camera name. Also, the shutter angle seems to have been moved, and also the version. So, okay, some new stuff here. I think that is great, but let's just jump into the next page. So here we have the shutter angle, which were on the other page before. Shutter speed, shutter angle. Again, a little more. Whoa. Okay, it can also now calibrate the LCD screen automatically.
and that you had a live test on right here. Cool. Okay, I'll say okay for that. Thank you. Okay, it's also going to calibrate the motion sensor. I guess that this means that this has something to do with the gyro stabilization. And my camera is now ready to be used. Okay, so I'm on not the second page, so I'll just jump back here on the second page. So it actually did that automatically. Cool it is, cool. So again, the things and the stuff on the menu has been changed around a bit. The menu system has been changed around a little bit, so that's going to take a couple of seconds to get used to. Okay, that is something about the network functionalities, I guess. We'll have to look into that. I'll go for the next page. And now I'm running out of pages. This is, again, Bluetooth name, which means that we can enable Bluetooth and hook up the phone. Wow, cool update.
So I very quickly had to go from the studio and back home because I forgot the cord for my iPhone, so I could try out the cloud functionalities. And then I just forgot to show you the deleting of clips function. So I'm going to turn on my pocket camera here, and I do hope you can see that, something like that. And I'm just going to push the card, and voila, here we have all of the clips on the card. And for instance, if we take this one here, I can push the trash can up here in the top corner, and then I can delete the clip, and I'm going to say, yes, I want to delete it. And it's now deleted. This is a super cool function now available in the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K, 6K and 6K Pro. Okay, so I did try to hook up my phone with the camera, and currently I am not smart enough to make that work, but I'm going to continue to try to make this work so I can shoot something on the camera and then upload it directly up to the cloud and into DaVinci Resolve. I know it works, I just have to figure it out. And I don't want to use time on figuring that out because I want to get this video out. Next test we'll just do very quickly will be see if we can use this as a webcam. So it is also possible to connect the camera to your, in this case, Mac, to use it as a webcam, and it actually works pretty well. So I have OBS open here on my screen, and then, you know, I'm just going to go into the camera which I have right here, and I'm going to turn on use as webcam. And if I go into the menu right here, I can see that Blackmagic just popped up, and I'm going to select that. So now when I take this off, I am now, recording using this as a webcam cam in OBS, and I can, of course, change the focus and focus the stuff nicely like that.
Okay, so that was the first look at the new update for the Blackmagic camera, the 8.6 update. I think it's a cool update. I think it's super cool that Blackmagic keeps on updating their cameras, and really, it's nice they're still doing that. So I am looking so much forward to what's coming up next from Blackmagic at the NAB show, just a couple of weeks away. So this was maybe a pre-announcement for what's going to come at NAB. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.